So,
excuse me, sir. Sir, can you do me a favor? Can you give me your tomato soup recipe? You know what I'm saying?
They
might want to know what's
What's the running joke with tomatoes? Because you started singing, then he started singing.
You know what I'm saying? You gotta tell
why
him.
Why tomato soup?
You gotta tell him. You gotta tell him. Pop, that's how Keith keeps strong. You gotta tell him.
Are you the chef?
Tell him. No, sir.
This is the food critic. That's what it is.
You made some chunky tomato soup?
I made some tomato soup. He thought it was god-awful. It was the best thing since tomato soup was invented. I'm telling you right now.
Campbell's called him for a recipe.
No, they called
him. Campbell's Gigi. Right.
No blasphemy on film.
I got to ask you one serious question, though. About 2 weeks ago, Andre Brudeau's dad passed.
I didn't know that.
You didn't know that?
No.
Do you remember him from the amateur?
I do.
Okay, tell us about him.
I didn't know him personally. I ran across him maybe on one or two occasions. I really didn't really have a lot of interaction with him. But I know that... Mike loved his dad. I know that. You know, I know him and his dad were close.
Yeah,
and I'm sorry to hear that. Rest in peace, you know?
Yeah. Good dude. Always took care of all his sons, daughters.
Yeah. I know. That's what I always heard was good things about him, you know? So I'm sorry to hear that from Mike, you know?
Yeah.
His family.
So there you have it. We're here in New York City. Weigh in today, tomorrow to fight. That's it?
Yeah.
How's the injury? Health? Everything's good?
Well, hey, I mean, you guys got to keep to ask those questions, you know? And, you know, he's ready for the fight. I mean, when we come Saturday night, he's going to show everybody why he's the number one. You know, even if he doesn't want to say he's number one, I'll say it for him, he's number one.
28-0, right?
You know what I'm saying?
22-9.
You know? So, you know, there's a reason why he got where he's at, you know? Everybody can say what they want to say, this and that about his layoff, ring rust, all these things. You know, it's no different than what's going on with Trump, you know? It's like a blow-by-blow description of everything he does. The man changes from Big Mac to damn cheeseburger, and it's on the news. You know what I'm saying? If Keith scratches his head with his left hand or his right hand, it's on the news.
But I will say this. Boxing was missing your son. He has a great personality.
Yeah.
He's good for the sport. When he fights, a big deal. He only fights the best. He doesn't take easy fights. This is not an easy fight.
I know it's not an easy fight. Josecito Lopez is a great fighter.
Big punch?
Yeah, he's a good puncher. A lot of people are talking crap about him taking a tune-up fight with Josecito. Josecito, in my opinion, is not a tune-up fight.
No, he's not. He's coming off a big win. He fought an 18-0 kid. He's been in the gym for 10 months training.
Yeah.
And every fight's dangerous at this level.
And he's got Mike, he's got the Garcia in his corner. You know, he's in a good position. You know, he's got Dan in his corner. He's in a good position. This is going to be a great fight. You know, all you guys out there don't have your tickets, get your tickets. You don't have your tickets, watch it on Fox for free.
My one question, emphasis on one. You said Keith Thurman is number one. What gives him the advantages over people say either Errol Spence, or your son is number one, or number two,
whichever one you pick. When I say number one, you guys refer to rankings and, you know, who's ranked here, give them different stock and stuff like that. When I say he's number one, of course, I'm a little biased. He's my son.
Absolutely.
But the thing is, yeah, just a little, man.
You're biased, sir? Just a little, man. Hey, you related? You don't look like
that. Yeah, well, we don't look alike, but we got the same DNA. Trust me when I tell you. Check his Y chromosome with my X chromosome. You come up with the same pheromone.
Have you ever done the
I don't need to do all that.
The DNA, just see your background, the family history, all that?
I don't want to do it. They're selling that information. They're selling that information.
They're keeping it. You're right.
They're farming it out.
Yeah. You're right. And that's how they catch criminals too, by matching DNA from the test.
Well, look.
It's public knowledge.
I ain't got nothing to worry.
No,
that
not
stuff
you.
That stuff was cleared 10 years ago. I ain't got to worry
about
nothing.
I'm not talking about that.
That's a joke.
But I'm saying that people don't know. I'm saying you do the DNA test and they keep it and it's open to everybody.
Yeah, well, like I said, there are certain companies with the money that are buying it now. You know, so to each his own on the DNA thing, you know what I'm saying? But, you know.
But Keith is your son.
He's all day, every day. You know what I'm saying? I claimed him before. I claimed him when he was born. I'm claiming him today. You know what I'm saying? All day, every day. Like all my other kids, you know what I'm saying? All my grandkids, I claim all of them. You know what I'm saying? So the thing is that, you know, when it comes down to when I said number one, I was talking about, you know, as far as the way he thinks in the ring, I don't think it's matched by other fighters in his weight class. You know, I don't see other fighters with that type of ring IQ. And that's why I say he's number one, you know?
How does the rematch play out with